pencil can be used underwater. It can be used to write on people's skin by surgeons during surgery. And the pencil can also be used in outer space. The astronauts actually use pencils because it's a lot easier to use a pencil as opposed to a pen because none of the elements affect the pencil use in space. Finally, I'd like to say that pencil, the mechanical pencil, was first patented in 1864 in the concept selection process. Consuelo Velasquez is our expert in the concept generation, and Jose Madrigal is our expert in the needs analysis, and Juan Sumantri is our expert in the target specifications. Let me give you a little bit of understanding of what we'll be covering.
And that is going to give us a total that we can see the one with the highest number, you can't really see it here, but the one with the highest number was our selected product. And that came out to be the mechanical. Once we were done with everything, we selected our product, we had to do reflection on what we did. We figured that our number of potential products was the good number. We had 11 potential products, and if it was bigger, it would have gotten more complicated, and the decision process would have been more and more complex. Therefore, we have selected a product, and the next step is to go ahead and apply the product development process to our product. Therefore, Jose is going to be talking to you guys about identifying customers.
Hi, my name is Jose Madrigal. I'm the needs analysis expert. And to basically demonstrate needs analysis, I have a pencil. And if you could tell me one thing that you like about the pencil. Okay, it has grip. It has, you know, you can think about weight, size, and other features like that. The needs analysis, as you know, is a process to identify what the customer wants. And our process consisted of 5 steps. They are, the first one is to develop a mission statement, then we conduct a survey, and from the survey we translated the information into needs. We took these needs and organized them and ranked needs. And then finally we review on the process. First of all, like I said, we developed the mission statement. The most important thing about the mission statement is that we describe the product. Our product, for example, is a comfortable, inexpensive, quality mechanical pencil for use for everyday use. Another important thing in the mission statement is our primary market, and for us, it was students. After this, we developed a survey. And the survey basically asks questions like, what do you like or dislike, and what improvements can you make to the pencil? We also had a list of what people consider when they buy the pencil. With the information from the survey, we then made a list of need statements, which is the following. And the important thing was that we listed what the product can do and how it does it. And as you can see, we also put numbers aside, and these refer to the survey. And this helps us to show how many times it came up in the survey. Then we took these needs, and we decided to organize them and rank them. The following was our result. We had headings for different things, and we had the needs under these headings. And we also ranked them. We ranked them relative to the highest, the most important need we had, and that was that the mechanical pencil can maintain a sharp edge. After the need statement was finished, we can review and reflect on the process. first piece of the process that we found successful was when we did the survey, the list of considerations can also help out.
My name is Juan Sumanti, and I'm the expert in target specification. And I'm going to be talking about target specification, BFN, key process tech, and summarizing what we covered today. And that was not good our presentation. First of all, we are in business. We are trying competition. We have our customer needs. So we're going to start our target specification. In this process, we basically convert what the customer wants or customer needs into the concept or the list of specification for the mechanical pencil. And those are the steps that we have to do in the target specification. That includes a list of matrix, collect competitive benchmark information, develop out of quality, click and results and process. And at the end of this process, we should have a list of specification and a concept. We work in the later process, which is concept generation and concept selection. And also, we also have started the design for manufacturing, and it includes estimating manufacturing costs, reduced cost of component, reduced cost of assembly, reduced cost of supporting production. And these are the two tests we have started. I want to go back to the Gantt chart. As you see here, this today's date, and we have finished our customer needs, and we just started the target and the EFM just a couple of days. So we don't have anything concrete work that we can show you for these two processes. So I'm just going to summarize what we covered today. Next thing I'm going to show is the key process check. This is the process that we do every 2 weeks. This is the process we had from the adapter from DCD-100. And we have a form here also that from DCD-100. And that like, basically, we just go over with our team and see what we're doing on and the last thing we're going to say is basically summarizing what we covered today is product selection. We have our product selection as mechanical pencil. And we did a brainstorm, the criteria, comparison matrix, and selection. And under needs analysis, we have our mission. We did our survey, translate survey. We have our needs up to the end. We're starting the target specification and the DFM. And that will conclude our presentation. And we are expected to have a comfortable, good quality mechanical pencil.
Could you put your needs back up, these are the hierarchy here on the needs, and zoom in on them a little bit so I couldn't read them. I'll look at those. Those numbers are
those are the
came up in the survey.
So it's based on the numbers kind of came up on the survey and what we felt.